Yeah, what a breeze.
Easy game.
Yeah, easy game, easy life. Didn't even have to think about that one at all. Alright. Alright.
So we probably want to play Nautilus in round one for Horn, so that we don't end up drawing Horn and having like issues with mulligans.
Yeah, but for now he hasn't developed Wolfsbane, so we just chill and play this, right? Unless you want to try to kill that. I actually don't think killing this is the worst.
I don't like it.
Okay, I mean, I'll take your word for it. If we burn the...
We can. I mean, it like wastes a Freya, I guess. But the rain actually seemed like it actually did a lot for us.
Okay, I did like that rain, so let's just do this then.
Yeah.
How are we stacking this game?
I think not middle. The problem with middle is like once you put two scouts there, your Reaver scout like pushes it over the Igni Tar.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah, having the scout deck is really nice with MO, just because it lines up so well. Because if not, then you have to like roll the dice on what you're getting.
Yeah, be right back. Okay. One sec.
I'm really surprised he's not playing this brand. There's a decent chance we can tempo him out. I think I'm just gonna do it.
I'm back.
Alright, welcome back. So yeah, I think this is good because it enables our battering ram if we want to kill Bran.
It's a pretty late Wolfsbane.
Yeah, that's another thing I was thinking about too, is it's pretty low tempo where he's at right now. I kind of like the ram. The other option...
Yeah, kill his
Yeah, ram. The other option is we Radovid and we lock like a veteran and Morkvorg, your call. He's not going to pass yet though, so we don't have to do it yet. We can just take ram value while it's here, if you want.
I like Radovid better.
Okay.
I like Radovid and locking.
Where do you want it? Not top, you want it ranged or back?
Why not top?
Igni.
Yeah, but he's Igni a 6.
Yeah, but we're gonna buff all those things. What if we play another scout and these all go to 6? Is it ram?
I think it's ram while we can still kill his...
Yeah, and then we're putting it probably here.
What's his Wolfsbane?
2.
Okay.
We're definitely killing the Bran. The question is where's the second shot going? Not here. Too much armorsmith value, Raider. Right? So just here.
Raider. Yeah, Raider.
Well, that's something. Okay. How do you feel about...
His Wolfsbane is ticking, it's gonna buff his Morkvorg, and it's gonna hit our ram right now. If we play Ronvid, it hits our Ronvid.
So how do you feel about the Ronvid? It gives him his pass, but... Maybe that's a reason to not Ronvid then. If we scout, it doesn't give him a pass. Does okay. Line up a potential Igni.
No, we have the... Oh,
because it hits the ram. I think are we okay if he ignies us though? Then we just pass, right?
Yeah, sure.
Do we wanna? Are we row stacking to block Harpooner? Because we might as well, right? The Igni screws us no matter what.
Okay, we just get
yeah,
out.
Yeah, we get out. Because
I mean, we have the luxury of red
yeah,
coins.
If we play Ronvid there, then he can just pass on the wolf spin. So I would have liked to have developed the Ronvid, but then he just passes,
right?
And we have to go a card down. So this is better. And now if he like dry passes us, we can safely develop Ronvid too, and he can't even get good coral value on it.
Yeah.
Alright, so we just kick the horn, I think.
Well, we didn't get to play our horn. And we're gonna get an infantry move.
Yeah, we have to actually kick this, right? No, I think I have no idea actually. I'm pretty sure we have to kick the horn. There's a chance we may have to play the infantryman here to fix mulligans. YOLO. Nailed it. Yeah, I don't know. It felt right. Like, it felt like it was probably the play. It felt risky, I agree, but
yeah. Ronvid.
Good Ronvid value. Because now he doesn't even want to correlate, so we just have like the permanent crewman tag.
Mm-hmm.
He already used his Igni, so we don't have to worry about this. So as long as we don't draw another one here, this is a good proactive play. So we'd love to see...
No, we just wrote... We just hard,
yeah, hard roast deck. We'd love to see Dijkstra, but that's okay.
No, we don't mulligan anything.
Yeah, yeah, because we're not... we're not guaranteed...
We don't want to get into...
Yeah, we're not guaranteed to find this anyway, so we keep it. No Dijkstra or Shani feels bad, man, but that's sort of our experience with the deck today.
Yeah, I feel like I haven't seen a Dijkstra this entire time.
Hey, Grim Paris, man, welcome back. Alright, I just want to leave with this.
We played that one Dijkstra where we were hoping we didn't get...
Yeah, Mandarina. The one Dijkstra where we beat that guy because he, like, randomly pushed us in round two and he just had, like, an infiltrator. But yeah, we just played the infantryman.
Sure. Margarita's kind of shitty.
Yeah, I agree. Something to maybe look at was maybe when we could have played this instead.
Fog? Okay.
So... Do we don't... Well, I mean...
Why don't we clear?
Yeah, I think we clear.
It's a lot.
It's a lot, yeah.
It's like 14 points. Problem is he can, like, decoy that. And we can't do anything. I actually don't want to kill the Grimmest anytime soon.
Yeah, restore. He doesn't have any like phenomenal restore targets right now. I agree. I don't want to kill it if I don't have to.
He has last say.
Yeah, last say, so we're gonna miss him.
We still wanna save Esco for
some, yeah,
sure.
So we probably ballista and then put like a shot here and a shot there, right? Or do you not want to put a shot there because it incentivizes decoy and we'd rather put two shots there? Or would you rather just horn?
What's
that's
wrong
what I say,
horn?
Would you rather just horn?
What's wrong with horn right now?
Yeah, that's horn.
Yeah.
And yeah, we hard roast deck. There's like no way he's gonna...
Do you wanna horn Ronvid? I don't think we horn Ronvid.
Okay, yeah, that's a fair point.
There's a decoy. Why didn't he? Oh, maybe he drew that off screen.
Yeah, I wasn't watching. It looked like he picked it up from the far left. So
far left. So
he had it.
Svanrigo should have gotten the card.
Yeah,
on the
yeah, it would be this. So he had it. He just elected not to. That's kind of weird. Okay. All right. Well, it's gonna be 12 value, so we just sort of live with it. I think we can do about it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's not crazy. It's like a little bit more than
yeah.
the bear.
I'm thinking we just... I mean, is this our best Margarita? Right? Like... I'd rather hold off on the machines for the time being, so I think we've Margarita.
I guess.
I mean, when she's good, she's like really good, right? But when she's bad, she's pretty bad. Like, she's so good against consume and stuff, but, like, another decks, like, and then, like, matchups like Skellige, she can be pretty bad. But she's even good against discard. She's just, like, pretty mediocre against, against veteran. But, like, against discard, she's still really good, too. Alright,
I still don't want to kill
Yeah, I don't either.
Like, what's in his graveyard? Like, he doesn't
yeah,
have
Yeah, no good restore
maidens,
targets.
Right?
Although, at the moment, restore is pretty meaningless for him. Because, like, let's say he restores Grimmest, right? What can he bear? Yeah. So,
that's true. But he can play a Freya and then restore
Yeah, but we can kill it. I think it's the Ballista and we spread out our shots.
Okay. I think we
ping here and here,
don't
right?
Hit the Grimmest.
Yeah, I agree. We don't hit the Grimmest because eventually we may be killing it at some point. Once we see, like, a restore or we feel that he doesn't have a good option for it. Okay. He doesn't want to miss any more value off of his coral from the fog, so...
Right. Yeah.
Makes sense.
Makes sense.
Yeah. Well, now if we want, we can Blista and we can put a shot here. We don't even have to worry about killing the Grimmest. How do you feel about that?
Yeah, so one on coral, one on Grimmest.
Yeah, I like it.
Skirmish.
That's what it looks like. I mean, I don't know what else you would ever pick here.
He could just discard a harpooner if he wanted.
I guess. Yeah, there's a skirmisher.
What did he
skirmisher.
Call?
So,
yeah. I don't think
no,
so.
No,
right?
He did.
Didn't he?
Nah.
Didn't he play a
skirmisher? Oh, you're right. He did randomly drop that. Okay, good. Good eye. Good eye. It was a harpooner. That's weird. I guess he doesn't need it.
He has... It probably means he has a maiden in hand.
Yeah, maiden in hand
and
a res.
A res in
so
hand.
we can brick this.
We can brick the maiden if we kill the...
So let's kill Coral.
Kill Coral.
And then let's put the shot, what you say, here.
Yeah.
We're
yeah,
still trying good. To deny armorsmith value.
So I think if we read him right and he has a maiden in hand, I think we can win.
I think even if we read him wrong, we still win, right?
Yeah, if we read him wrong, we still win.
I guess last rate. Can lacerate somehow get us here?
Maybe we should have.
Lacerate would have been close.
Yeah,
it was close, but I'm pretty sure it was a maiden. It read like a maiden.
Yeah, instant forfeit.
Yeah, the maiden made the most sense given his like playstyle. So yeah.
Yeah.
We basically played around everything that made sense, and we disrespected the deck. That's like the nice thing about when like deck lists are very public and stuff is. You can just like totally disrespect cards like Harpooner because you know they can't punish you with Lacerate.
Yeah.